हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम एनके जैन फ्रॉम स्किल ऑन टेक। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट एक्सियल थ्रस्ट बैलेंसिंग इन सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स एंड कंप्रेसर्स। दिस इज माय थर्ड वीडियो इन लाइन ऑफ हाइड्रोलिक थ्रस्ट प्रोड्यूस्ड इन पंप्स एंड कंप्रेसर्स एंड हाउ टू मैनेज दीज थ्रस्ट बाय टेकिंग सुटेबल मेजर्स। हाउ एक्सियल थ्रस्ट इज प्रोड्यूस्ड, यू कैन सी ए पिक्चर ऑफ ए इम्पेलर वेयर two forces are showing, F2, F1, and unbalanced thrust is also shown. The axial impeller force F unbalance is the difference between the axial forces on the discharge side F2 and suction side F1 impeller shroud. Hence, F unbalance equal to F2 minus F1. The axial thrust component F1 plus Fm of closed impellers, that is with suction side shrouds which are not hydraulically balanced, is Fm equal to rho q delta Vax. In this equation, q is equal to flow rate, rho equal to density of the fluid handled, and delta Vax difference between the axial components of the absolute velocity at the impeller inlet and outlet. Let us know what are the measures for axial thrust balancing in pumps and compressors. Angular contact bearings, self-aligning ball or roller bearings, tilted pad thrust bearings, those are bush and sleeve type. Balance hole in impellers, balance hole are provided in the pump impellers to balance the axial thrust. Back vane in impeller, a pump out vane or an additional small vane is provided in the pump impeller to balance the axial thrust. Double suction. Double suction pumps are manufactured to balance the axial thrust by opposite magnitude of the axial thrusts. Back to back impeller arrangement. If impellers are arranged in a pump in a back to back position, then also axial thrust of the pumps are nullified. Balancing disc. A balancing disc device is provided in the centrifugal pumps to balance the axial thrust. In a balancing disc, there is a one rotating disc and one is a counterpart of a balancing disc, that is called a stationary disc. So by making this balancing disc arrangement, axial thrusts are managed. Balancing disc and drum. This is also a combination of balancing disc and drum where axial thrust is managed in the pumps. But in compressors, generally tilted pad thrust bearings are provided to manage the axial thrust. Balance hole. You can see a picture of an impeller where balance hole is shown. You can see this is a balance hole. So by providing a balance hole in impeller, you can see the axial thrust is balanced. Balance hole in the impeller of a centrifugal pump are drilled into the rear shroud. Here you can see this. The role of balance hole in the impeller is to balance the pressure on each side of the impeller and reduce load on the bearing. So there are two pressures, you can see here, this is a high pressure, this is also high pressure. So here it is a intermediate pressure and this is a low pressure. This is a suction side of the impeller. So by providing a balance hole, you can see the net axial thrust can be reduced. The balance hole connects the back of the impeller with the inlet area where pressure is low. Axial thrust reduction by balancing hole. A picture is shown to demonstrate how axial thrust reduction by balancing hole. You can see in this picture that this is a suction side and this is a discharge side. Discharge and this is a suction side. So you can see the pressures. Here it is a suction pressure and here it is a low pressure and this is a डिस्चार्ज प्रेशर. सो इफ वी विल मेक ए बैलेंस होल इन द दिस इम्पेलर, सो द डिस्चार्ज प्रेशर विल पास फ्रॉम हियर टू सक्शन साइड दिस साइड एंड देन द टोटल थ्रस्ट ऑफ बोथ साइड्स विल बी ट्राइंग टू बैलेंस. सो हैंस दिस मच ऑफ एरिया विच इज शोन हियर इज ए रिडक्शन इन द एक्सियल थ्रस्ट by making a balance hole. So up to a some extent axial thrust is managed by making a balance hole in the impeller. Discharge side ceiling clearance. Axial thrust is also managed by providing a discharge side ceiling clearance in tandem with balance hole. You can see a picture of balance hole here. This is a balance hole provided. And here it is a discharge side inner clearance between impeller and casing, and this is a suction side outer clearance between impeller and casing. You can see these are the balance holes provided in the discharge side of the impeller. This balance hole is also provided to reduce axial thrust in combination of clearance provided between impeller and impeller casing ring. So you can see here this is a discharge pressure P2, and here also it is a discharge pressure P2. The axial thrust is balanced here, but here it is a suction pressure P1, and this is a pressure which is discharge pressure coming after throttling from this clearance gap and become a lower pressure. So this is also a some lower pressure but equalized through a balance hole. So this both the pressures will be equalized and axial thrust will be managed. So inner and outer ring of double wear ring act as a throttling gear leading to pressure equalizing, while balance holes act as the controlling wall. Suction side wear ring are designed to limit the flow of pumpage from the high pressure discharge side of the impeller to lower pressure suction side. Excessive clearance of these rings can result in increased flow across the suction side and a volumetric loss of efficiency. Rear wear rings, when present, work in tandem with balance hole that pass through the suction eye to lower the suction side pressure behind the impeller and inside the rear wear ring, limiting the axial thrust force. So now you can see this inner wear ring discharge side inner clearance between impeller and casing is provided with tandem with the balance hole. So this is also one very important method to balance the axial thrust in a single stage centrifugal pump with single suction double entry impeller. You can see a picture of a pump impeller where the entry of suction is from both side of the pump. Now you can see from here as well as from this direction. So what will happen? The pressure of the impeller shrouds at both sides will remain same. So axial thrust component produced by discharge cancel each other and axial thrust is nullified. So double entry impellers are also a suitable measure to balance the axial thrust in centrifugal pumps. Back-to-back arrangement of impeller. You can see a picture of back-to-back arrangement of impellers. There are two impellers, impeller number 1, impeller number 2, and they are arranged back-to-back. So what happened? The axial thrust produced by both the impellers कैंसल टू ईच अदर. सो हियर इट विल दिस दिस इंपेलर विल गिव डिस्चार्ज हियर एंड दिस विल गिव हियर. तो दिस डायरेक्शन विल बी अपोजिट टू ईच अदर एंड सक्शन विल ऑल्सो नलिफाई टू ईच अदर. सो दिस इज शोन हियर. बैक टू बैक इंपेलर पंप्स आर फिटेड विद सेवरल इंपेलर्स इन बैक टू बैक अरेंजमेंट ऑन अ कॉमन पंप शाफ्ट. दिस इज एन इफेक्टिव मीन्स ऑफ बैलेंसिंग द एक्सियल थ्रस्ट अकरिंग ड्यूरिंग द ऑपरेशन ऑफ ए सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप विदाउट रिक्वायरिंग ए सेपरेट बैलेंसिंग डिवाइस. सो दिस अरेंजमेंट इज ऑल्सो वेरी वाइडली यूज इन द सेंट्रीफ्यूगल पंप्स फॉर बैलेंसिंग एक्सियल थ्रस्ट. बैक वेन्स पंप आउट वेन और बैक वेन इज प्रोवाइडेड ऑन इम्पेलर डिस्चार्ज एंड टू रिड्यूस थ्रस्ट एरिया टू रिड्यूस एक्सियल थ्रस्ट. यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर ए पंप आउट वेन इज और बैक वेन इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द इम्पेलर डिस्चार्ज साइड. हियर यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर दैट बाय प्रोवाइडिंग ए बैक वेन और ए पंप आउट वेन यू कैन रिड्यूस दिस मच ऑफ एक्सियल थ्रस्ट दिस एरिया विच इज शोन हियर. So this is a reduction of axial thrust by providing a back vane. So this measure is also taken in centrifugal pumps and compressors to reduce axial thrust. Self-balanced multi-stage pumps. The self-balancing multi-stage centrifugal pump is a new multi-stage centrifugal pump concept that has been innovated and improved on the basis of the conventional multi-stage pump. The impellers are arranged symmetrically and the water outlet of the pump is located in the middle of the positive and reverse impellers. The symmetrically impellers make the axial thrust balance out and no axial movement. Here in this picture you can see these are the positive impellers and these are the negative impellers. The discharge will be from the common from here. So the axial thrust produced by the positive impellers and negative impellers will be cancelled to each other and a very minimum axial thrust will remain on the shaft and that will be managed by the thrust bearings only. Self-balanced multi-stage pump. You can see a picture of a self-balanced multi-stage pump here. Here you can see these are the positive impellers and these are the negative impellers, which we have already discussed. The discharge is from here, common discharge of all the negative and positive impellers. So the axial thrust produced by the impellers is cancelled to each other. So there is a very less axial thrust remain on the shaft and that is managed by the angular contact bearings which are provided in the pump. Due to very minimum axial thrust on the shaft, the mechanical seal provided will have a very long life because the axial movement of the shaft is very less, hence mechanical seal remain healthy for a longer period. So this is also an added advantage to these pumps. These pumps are new generation pumps. Other measures for axial thrust balancing. Balancing disc arrangement. Balancing disc and drum arrangement. These two arrangements are also used in multi-stage pumps to manage the axial thrust. We will discuss in detail about both the methods in my upcoming videos. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, hit like button below, share it with your friends and colleagues, subscribe our channel for getting updates on upcoming videos. Please leave any comments, feedback to improve the videos. Thank you.